In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make a Splatoon poster from start to finish. And I'm gonna try to waste as little time as possible while still covering pretty much everything important. So after you have downloaded SFM and booted it up, you'll get to this screen and here you can name the session. It doesn't really matter as long as you can keep track of them. I like to name my sessions by the date I started to work them on, but for this I'm gonna name it Very Epic. Like that. And your layout probably doesn't look like this. And how to change it, you have to go to Windows, Layouts, and here. You probably have default, but I like to use the sound editing layout. And I'm not editing sound, it's just I like the layout, that's it. First we need to load up a map, so just right click, load map, and search for, well, since I'm doing Splatoon, I'm gonna search for a Splatoon map. And Splatoon stuff isn't pre-installed, you have to download it from the workshop. Just go to Steam Workshop and you know. Let's try Octo Valley. There we go. So now we can move up. I'm all the way down here. I'm gonna use this viewport for my work camera and the secondary viewport for the camera for the poster, so I can work on the poster while always seeing the result. I think this spot can be good. And how to move around, you hold down left click and use WASD and Z to move up and X to move down. First, I like to place down a camera, so right click, create camera, and then switch to it here, like that. Then select the camera. And now you can't move it, and that is because you need to choose the motion editor. So now you can move it and scroll to increase or decrease the FOV. Where was I? Here, I think. Yeah, here. So I want to place... I'm not quite sure yet. So for now, I'll just put it here. So now we want to add a model. So right click, create animation set for a new model. And here we can search for Inkling, if you have it installed. Inkling Girl. I want to use the Inkling Girl alt model, because I want to change the hairstyle. You need to use the alt model to change the hairstyle. So I want pink eyes. So here we have it. First, I like to open up the eyes. So drag this to the right and these two, like that. Now the eyes are open and I want to change the hair color. So just right click, add override materials, then right click again, show an element viewer, model, then expand materials. And here, Inkling Girl team color. And here you can change, okay, this is the eyebrows only. But since we're gonna change out the hair anyway, we only need to change the eyebrows. So I also want it to be pink to match the eyes. So I'm gonna right click and copy the color so I can use it later. And then go back here to animation set editor. And now I'm gonna search for a different hairstyle. I want this hair, girl shortcut. This one. So just right click, add override materials, show in element viewer, model, expand materials, and here you can change the color. So here we can right click and paste the exact same color. So now we want to replace the hair. So what you need to do is right click, show an element viewer, model, expand materials again, and then here, Inkling Girl team color alt, expand that, right click, add attribute, string, and type in $alpha. There we go. Now it's transparent, but we still have this. So here, we need to do it on this one as well. String, $alpha, and the hairband as well. String, alpha. There we go. So now we can go back to animation set editor. So we need to expand this, expand body, and do the same for the Inkling Girl model body, and then drag this bip head on top of the bip head on the shortcut model, and then select bip head here, and drag this zero slider to the right. Like that. So now we have a different hairstyle. We can collapse these like that. We can also change the underwear here. Inkling underwear and change to whatever you want. And we can also go here and change the color of it. So since we changed it to the second one, we need to also do that here. So I'm gonna paste in the same color to match it. So there we go. And don't forget to save. So Control S or here. File save. So now we want to add some clothes. So search for Splatoon clothing and find one you like. And if you don't already have these, go to the workshop and search for them. I think I want a regular t-shirt. So t-shirt, long sleeved t-shirt, this one. The easiest way to put it on is just take this model, the Inkling Girl model, and drag it on top of the shirt and then release. And then select it and drag the zero slider to the right. There we go. And let's say I want to change the skin. I want to change the skin of the shirt. So right click, set skin, and here you can, well, change it. This one is nice. And if you're not happy with the, let's say, I want to change the underwear again. So bam, like that. But then you see the color isn't right. So we need to fix that. So show an element viewer, model, materials, and it's this one. It's because it's, well, the first one. So paste it in. There we go. So now we want to add some shoes. So Splatoon shoes. Let's go with the high tops. These. And we can change the skin as well. Yeah, these. So the same again. Drag the Inkling Girl model on top of the shoes. Then select the shoes and drag the slider to the right like that. And don't forget to save. Control S. Perhaps we want to add something on her head, like a hat, a beanie, or whatever. Headgear. So let's see what we can find. Yeah, this one. So the same again, drag the Inkling model on top of the beanie and select the beanie and drag the zero slider to the right like that. This comes with a mask, and let's say you don't want the mask. So right click, set body groups, here face mask, none. There we go. So let's say I'm happy with this. Now we can start posing the model. So select the Inkling model, select the move tool, and now we can move it around. And I'm gonna put her on the ground here with the tree, I think could be a good spot. So let's put her here. So now we want to pose her. Posing is quite hard, at least for me. So just expand and find the right parts. I think I want her to be like very excited and happy. So I'm gonna make her stand on one leg. So there, find the foot. Like that, find the other leg, and bend it. Bend the spine a bit. I need to think about this for a bit. Okay, I'm gonna try to do the pose myself in real life. It does actually help. So the arm, bend it a bit, rotate. So posing isn't something you will learn like after a tutorial or something. It is very hard to pose. I'm still quite shit at posing. It's just something you will get better at after some time. Let's start with this one instead. I'm gonna pose the fingers and do like a V sign, a peace sign, or a victory sign, or whatever. I'm gonna bend these two fingers. I'm trying to look at my own hand to see how it looks, but if you look at the finger, it only bends here. But if you look at your own finger, it's not the same. I can't talk today for some reason. And here I am trying to make a tutorial, sort of. Okay, I think that's fine for now. I think I'm gonna tweak it later. But now I want to actually pose it correctly. Now I'm gonna pose the arm. I think I need to pose the head first, here. Something like that, I think. I'm gonna rotate this and this. Make sure you don't rotate on only one part of the arm, because if you do, this will happen. That doesn't look very nice. And also, Control Z is undo, or here, edit, undo. I think the camera will be here somewhere. You know what? Let's actually take the camera. First select it, and now we can move it there. It won't be exactly here, but it at least gives me an idea of where it will be. Bend the hand a little bit. Not sure about that. Oh! Well, that that's just great. Fuck's sake. Overflow. Damn it. That's why you should save very often, so you don't lose any progress. Switch to work camera and motion editor. Yeah, I didn't lose much progress, so it's fine. Now I need to pose the head again. So make sure you save often so that doesn't happen. But now I can try something else. Adjust the eyes a little bit, like here. I'll go back to it later. Then I want her to make the peace sign with her right arm, so I'm gonna reset the left arm. And how to do that is I select everything. Hold down control, by the way, so you can select multiple parts. And also the hand. And just right click, import sequence. And here, idle, open. And there we go. Don't forget to save. So now I'm gonna make the peace sign. it's quite hard to see in this rotation. I probably should have moved the arm, but I'm already committed. I think that's fine. So save. And now I can move it up, rotate a bit more, move it up a bit more. I think that's all right. So now I'm gonna select the camera, and also you can change, I said you can change the FOV by scrolling, but you can also change the lens here. 35, I'll put it here for now. So now I want to pose the other arm, but I'm not sure what to do with it. I want it to look natural, but at the same time, but it is not easy, you know? Okay, that'll have to do. I can't come up with anything else right now. So let's move on to the face, because this facial expression is quite boring. So I'm gonna change it. Maybe I want the right eye to be closed. I want the eyebrows to be a bit more up. Something like this. Now at this point, I usually go through everything and adjust some stuff here and there to make it look a bit better. So I want to adjust the hair a little bit, just a tiny bit, so it goes more in like that direction. It is subtle, but it does look better. And now I want to change the position. So I'm gonna select both the camera and the Inkling Girl, like here. So now you see more of the tree. So now I want to change the camera position. So I can rotate by holding down R and moving my mouse, so I can make the pose look more interesting. Perhaps I want to change the lens to 50. So now I want to add some props. So since it's a Splatoon map, ink round, and I want it to be the same color. Damn it, I don't have it pasted anymore. Here, copy and paste it. Like that. You can barely see it. Copy it, paste it, so I don't have to do everything again. Like there, and then paste it again. And this, I want to be bigger, so I'm gonna expand it. Go to body. So right-click on root transform, and add scale control to transforms. And here I can scale it up. So now, I want to add some layering. So first I want to go to the camera and turn down the tone map scale a little bit, like that, so we have more to play around with. So right click and create animation set for new light. So now we have a light here. It's very bright, so we want to turn it down, like that. I want to make it more orange, like that, because I want to have some kind of sunlight. And then I want to increase the FOV, because the sun is not just a light bulb. No! Okay, what did I lose this time? Okay, pretty much nothing. Great. Okay, so add a new light, turn up the FOV, make it more orange, turn down the intensity, also the tone map scale. I want the sun to come from here, like behind her, sort of. So I'm gonna put it here. And also, if you right click and enable light frustum, it's easier to see where the light is coming from, because you get these lines, but you want to disable them later. But it's just to make it easier to work with. I like to increase the intensity so I can really see where it's coming from, and then decrease it if needed. More up there, and then I want to copy it and also disable right frustum and paste it, because I also want to light up the place all around here. And since this doesn't really need any shadows, I'm gonna disable shadows, because you can only have, like, not sure exactly how many, but around 9 lights that has shadows, so it's good to save on as many as possible. So I'm gonna disable what I don't need, also disable light frustum. Remember, you only want to light up where you can see it in the poster, because why light up this place if you can't even see it? It will just make it laggier without any reason to have it that. And when adding all of these lights, you'll notice it starts to become very laggy. And that is, well, because light is quite intensive, so, well, it makes sense. So let's say I'm happy with this lighting, so now I want to change the camera settings a little bit. Like, you can change the tone map scale or something, I don't know. You can also change the bloom scale to, well, increase or decrease the bloom, but actually do want a little bit, but not much. Just a tiny, tiny bit. And I'm gonna set the focal distance, which is where the focus point is. So just drag it to where you want it. I want it on her face, like there. And then turn up the aperture. And then when you select the clip editor, you'll see you have some blur in the background. If you really turn up the aperture, you'll see the background is blurry. I want a little bit of, like that, I think. And now we want to change something else. Right click, render settings, and set this to 1024. And that will remove the ugly grain you see here. You see now it's gone. So that is very good to know. I think I'm pretty happy with how it looks. So now we're gonna export it and do some editing in paint.net, because when I make posters, I always edit it in post to, well, enhance the look of it. But first, save and close SFM, and then go to, well, Source Filmmaker here, and go here, manage, properties, and here, launch options. And you want to type in this. This will set SFM's resolution to 4K, but if your computer can't handle it, like it crashes when rendering or something, you can turn it down to 1080p. So this is 1080p, which is still higher than SFM's native resolution, which is 720p. So I'll have both in the description, but I'm gonna use 4K. So just launch SFM. So now it will tell you the game window is smaller than SFM resolution, but it's nothing to worry about, so just click OK and open your project. So now just go to File, Export Movie, and why we're not gonna export it as a poster or image is because you might run into some issues. But if you happen to run into some issues when exporting it as a movie, then you can choose poster. But if you can, choose movie. So select your output path. So choose image sequence, format PNG. You can choose JPEG or something else, but I like to have PNG. No separate WAV file. Set it at 4K or 1080p if you chose that. Set this at custom, set this at frames, this at 0, and this at 1. And that will render out one frame of the quote-unquote animation, which is just a poster. And there we go, now it's done. And if it crashed while exporting, you might have to turn down the resolution to 1080p. If it still crashes, try to restart your computer. And if that doesn't even work, then you can choose poster or another resolution. So now I'm gonna edit the poster in paint.net, because that's a program I always use. So one thing I can already tell what we can do is, you see here, up here, we have the sky. It's quite dark, but we added light, so it looks like it's supposed to be bright, but the sky isn't. So we can change that by duplicating the layer, go to adjustments and brightness and contrast, and turn it up quite a bit, like a lot, like that. And then go to adjustments, hue and saturation, just up it a little bit, like that. And I'll drag it down so we have this layer at the top. Now pick the eraser, turn down the hardness, turn up the brush width, and just erase some of this to make it brighter. Like that. Now it looks like it actually is quite bright outside. What you can also do is change the aspect ratio of it. So I want it to be more like a square. So go to image and canvas size, change it to, well, a square. So these will be the same. So now it's more like a square, but you can't really predict where it will go. Now I want her to be more in the middle. So undo and flatten the image, so we only get one layer. Control C to copy it, then change the canvas size. Okay, and now paste it in, Control V, keep canvas size, and now you can place it where you want it and make sure it's aligned properly, like that, something like that. That looks a bit better actually, because everything else was quite empty. So to enhance it even more, you can go to adjustments, brightness and contrast again, and tweak it a bit, and go to hue and saturation and do the same. Now it's way more bright and colorful. You can also go to adjustments again, and if you have the plugin, you can go to Color Balance Plus and tweak the colors. And I have a video covering how to download it. It's not very hard. So I want the shadows to be something like that, I think. And I want to go there again, reset these. And I want the midtones to be a bit more warm. So yellow and red, kind of like that, I think. There we go. And I can also add a new layer and just pick orange and go to more and turn up the brightness a bit of it, like that. And then pick the paintbrush and turn down the brush width a lot. Turn up the hardness, something like that. Then put down some random dots here and there, like that. And turn up the brush width. We want some variation in it. You need to up the hardness to compensate. Maybe even smaller dots. Make sure it's varied. You don't want the same size everywhere. So now we go to properties down here. and change the blend mode to screen, and then change opacity. Now it kind of looks like those out of focus particles, which I think looks pretty cool. We can change the saturation of them a little bit. I think they can be a bit more colorful. I think I went overboard with the brightness here. I think that looks pretty neat. We can go to image and flatten to make it a single layer, then copy, then undo, then make a new layer, put it at the top, and paste. So now I have every layer in a new layer. So now we want to go to effects and Asmageddon tools. This also requires a plugin, which I have a video covering that again. Sorry for the plug. Channel shift, which will make that kind of RGB shift effect. Only like two, I think it's fine. Like that. So let's say we're happy with this. So I want to save it. So just go to file, save as. Make sure to set it at PNG because PDN is a paint.net project file, and PNG, JPEG, and all of these are like file formats you can actually like upload to websites. I'll go with PNG and name it Happy Inkling. Okay, flatten. And there we go! So that is how to make a Splatoon poster, and also how to edit it afterwards. And I try to not waste any time because I don't want the video to be too boring and try to explain unnecessary stuff and such. If you want a more detailed tutorial, I don't have one right now, so you'll have to go somewhere else. But if you watch this in the future and I somehow have one, I'll put it in a card in the top right corner or in the description. So that's it for the video, so thanks so much for watching and bye!